Hey guys, so we're back. 1 Samuel 30. We talked yesterday about how there was this place, Ziklag, that David, had all of his mighty men's people there, and they were out doing the will of God. And basically, Ziklag was sieged. All this stuff, and people were downcast. His mighty men, they were brokenhearted. They were all mourning because they lost all their men, or the women, all of their livestock, all of their children. And then finally, after taking that moment, David consults God and he asks, should I pursue them? Will we overtake them? Like, will we recover what we have taken or what was taken from us? And God says, pursue, overtake, and recover all. And the first word that there is the pursue word. And that pursue word, as I mentioned yesterday, like there was a moment, and there's no shame in it. It's not something that you should dwell in if you can, but like you shouldn't beat yourself up whenever you are, kind of stuck, maybe a little bit in the rut of feeling this emotional start. And but that being said, the next part, this pursue, this is how you get out of the rut. The pursue word that's going on here is a word that means pursue and overtake. So the fact, we'll talk a little bit tomorrow about that word overtake, why he said it again, but this is a pursue and overtake. It's pursuing with a purpose, but it doesn't necessarily always have a destination, but it's about moving forward, moving after something. So if you find yourself in one of these ruts, if you find yourself in a situation or in a place where you're kind of stuck in that emotional rut, the just overwhelming sadness just kind of overtaking you, as you're fighting off the depression, the first thing that God says is pursue. And this is the same word that he says whenever it's pursuing righteousness. Now notice that righteousness does not have a destination. Whenever we're pursuing righteousness, we have to wake up every day and pursue righteousness. We have to get up and we have to renew ourselves to pursue after it. And so in the same way, if you're fighting something, if you're, trying to get out of that rut, it's time to move towards something. He doesn't necessarily, like in this case, it's pursuing after the things that they lost, right? Pursuing after the company. But in many ways, this pursuing it, because it has an idea of a destination but doesn't necessarily have one, this pursuing is what moves you out of zigzag, that place that you thought was safe, that place that you thought was good, and it puts you in a new place to where you can then hear God in a different way, and that God can make other promises to you, or that you can move out of just the rut that you're in. But you gotta start by moving forward. So I highly recommend, if it's you, if you're, fighting out of something, pursue. You can always change your mind on what you're pursuing after you make the move, but sitting in one spot, waiting, or just sitting in your own rut doesn't get you anywhere. It's time to move. Thanks for taking a minute.